Collins.
Deja vu about this whole thing now?
Yeah, it's wild. It's it almost went on too long, you know. But the marvelous part about it is we're able to recognize these folks here who 10 years ago, some of them bring us kids now who are college students when they started. They said, here are the new trackers.
Can this go on and on and on?
Well, I hope what goes on and on is the belief that we talked about, that we're all one people on one planet, and it's time for us all to get together and go on to the next step of the adventure, which is out there somewhere.
This has not been an easy movie to make. for you.
It has not been.
There have been some serious problems along the way.
You can't make science fiction without problems. It's just too complex. But that's part of the fun and excitement and challenge of making it, is have the problems.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jane.
Concerns that we do an important piece of work so that we not simply take advantage of the fact that Star Trek is popular, but add something to the Star Trek idea.
Are you confident you've added something?
I'm quite confident that we have, yes. I'm very proud of the work that we've done.
What do you think you've added to the concept of Star Trek?
I think the picture will answer that question probably a lot better than I could in a few words.
Promoted back to Admiral again, sir.
Promoted back to Admiral?
Yes.
Yeah, but demoted quickly thereafter to be a captain of it.
Why do you think the series is so popular?
I think these people love the people in the show, I guess. I really don't know. I'm kind of in awe of the whole thing myself. In fact, I'm a fan.
Thank you.
Have you seen the movie yet?
No, nobody has seen the movie except the brass at Paramount. So we're just as excited to see it as everybody else. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
This is from the Virginia Association.
You were going to do it.
You did.
I heard on national news. Yeah.
Was it Paul Harvey?
I don't know.
I think it was Paul Harvey.
And we were so excited.
We're like, funny thing, we're in bed. And we're holding hands, you see.
Yeah.
And so we're kind of so we have to plug in.
Who was it that I was with? He has it.
Yeah. And wasn't it nice you were asked? You should have been.
It's around some terrific. I'm not far
off. Oh, it's terrific.
It was really exciting. God, you're on the national news.
I know, and you know, there's some very nice people
from
CBS in particular.
Well, they should. You're one of the very important people.
Well, it was
great.
That's
great.
We thank you. If we're not for you, we wouldn't be. And I still have my two autumn leaves.
Yes, those leaves you sent us, they were so beautiful.
Yeah.
We love them.
This is a great lady. This is,
can I be a fan and ask you?
I want you to be.
Excuse me, Mr. Nick.
Yeah.
I'm sticking up for CBS News.
Hello, how are you?
I have like two or three questions.
Yes.
Thank you. We tried last week, I'm sorry to barge in, but...
Are you rolling?
Almost ready.
Okay.
We have not seen the movie. I gather you didn't see it until this evening. We'll see it tomorrow. Did you like it? What did you think?
I'm very pleased. I think it's a wonderful accomplishment. Mystery, adventure, touching, personal film. And I think finally it ends up saying some very interesting and remarkable things about the future of mankind.
You were one of the last holdouts. How do you feel about deciding to go ahead?
There's a common misconception that I was a holdout. There's also a common misconception that I was finally bought. The facts are very simple. I was simply not available when the project was first in preparation. I was in New York doing Equus on Broadway when Paramount decided they wanted to go into production during October of last year. They canceled that particular project at that time. It was to be a television project, actually. And as a result of that cancellation, and then my becoming available because I finished with my Equus commitment on Broadway, I was able to do the film. It's just that simple.
All of the principals, the actors, Mr. Roddenberry, have all said that no one really made very much money on the television series. Is it fair to say that this is finally catch-up for everybody?
Oh, I don't know. I'm really not in the mood at the moment to talk about the dollars. I'd really much rather talk about the elation I feel about what this motion picture is.
Well, what do you feel?
I feel very elated about it. I feel very positive. I'm proud to be part of it. I'm delighted that I was available when they finally decided to actually do the...
Well, have you not been ambivalent about the role and the fact that you had been typecast?
If you were to read the book, I think you would discover that it has not to do with a rejection of the character. It's a study of what it is to be an actor who has an alter ego, who is readily identifiable and highly visible and has a following of his own. Spock is a very dear friend of mine. I really am not Spock. I play him, and I enjoy being him when I am doing the role, but I am really not Spock. We have two different identities. The book is really a study of that fact and the phenomenon of being involved in that kind of relationship with a character who is so widely known and liked.
Part of what I have done, and I am ashamed to say I haven't read the book, but I admit it, is to go to Massachusetts and talk to Shirley Mayevsky, who's head of one of the Star Trek clubs. Well, she's here tonight. Perhaps you'll meet her. She said that the thing that was so important about Star Trek in the 60s was that it didn't destroy monsters. When it did, it was with great reluctance that it spoke about brotherhood. We've gone back and looked, and we'll show Saturday on the CBS Evening News some of the television series dealing with Vietnam in 1966. for you, is this movie as politically relevant as that television series was 10 years ago?
I'm not sure that I could relate it specifically to politics. I don't think it's about any particular current political issue. But I think there's an overriding concept that we as a planet are dealing with the future of mankind, not the future of Americans, not the future of any other particular country or even other planets. We are part of a federation of planets.